quiet. The kids are having hummus and carrots, and I want some hummus and carrots, so I am just going to make some Slimming World hummus. So I've got some chickpeas. I'm going to do a I'm going to microwave maybe two cloves of garlic, and just sort of does like a kind of a quick roast garlic. So I'm going to do that, and then I'm going to put in some quark, I think, either that or some cottage cheese. Quark makes it quite smooth, and cottage cheese kind of makes it so gloopy. I'm going to put some lemon juice in, and some bit of salt and pepper, and some paprika. So I will microwave the garlic. I'm just going to put the microwave on for about 10 seconds. I think that should be good. I'm just looking at it now. That'll do, I think. I've done one of them. The other one just needs a few more seconds, so I'm going to do it in this jug here. Just soften them a little bit. So then I'm just going to cut off the end bits. Just slice that up. It saves it just being totally not really raw. Then I'll put that in there with the, just make sure it's a bit less clumped up. I'll put that in with these chickpeas. These chickpeas are pretty good because they are like at Sainsbury's, they're a cheaper version of the Sainsbury's own brand chickpeas, about 10p cheaper. There's a dent in the tin, so that's not making it any easier. Red garlic in there. I've got a couple of cloves. I've got a tin of chickpeas. I am going to put in there some lemon juice, which I think this is free, just lemon juice. Like per tablespoon, per teaspoon is 1 calorie, so I think we're safe there. I'm going to put some of that in there. I think I probably put about a tablespoon maybe. I think I like plenty of lemon juice. I'm going to put some salt. I'm going to put some pepper in. And I'm going to put some paprika in, I think. Get your snacks. Okay, and then I'm going to it with a hand blender. I'll just pause it now, otherwise you'll just be listening to a hand blender. The alarm went off mid pause so I could put two videos together. My alarm was for me to go get Goya when it's to go get my daughter when it's quiet day. So basically, didn't realise it was quite as late as it was, 4:15. So I'm going to put in some, she's no wonder I'm a bit snackish, so I'm going to put in some quark, I think, this time I decided. So I'm going to put in, it's quite, the consistency at the moment is, it's quite stodgy. Let me just chuck that everywhere. It's quite stodgy, so I want it to be a little bit smooth. Be cautious that it doesn't tip itself over. So I'm going to put maybe 1, 2, 3 teaspoons of quark in there. Just sort of see how it goes. Like hummus. So I think I'm going to make myself some, chop up myself some carrots now, and then have a snack. I might make myself a hot drink, some decaffeinated coffee, and sit and just have a little chill out before I, what's it now, 4:15, so I've been trying to tidy the living room. But that hasn't quite worked out. 4:15. I've got to start making dinner at about 5:00. So I reckon after a quick break, I might just do 30 minutes worth of tidying the living room, and then whatever gets done is whatever gets done. Okay, so I'm going to do a little video as well of the finished product. I can put it on a plate and make it look fancy. Okay. There we go, I'll just spin it around and put it on a plate. There we are. And now I've just got to find something to put the leftovers in, which is where I need one of the little pots that Jane Day was talking about. Little tiny individual hummus pots. So I can store it. But what I might do is put it in. It's going to be a bit too crazy. But my mum gave me these old Pringle containers, I don't know whether you remember, ages ago, used to be able to get these little ones where you'd have like a little, put a couple of Pringles, or like a little, I don't know, mouthful of Pringles at that point, really, innit? I might put some hummus in it instead, because there's not a lot there, and I reckon I can fill it in, and then I've got like a little thing there. That's very apt in a sort of change of healthy eating kind of way to put your Slimming World hummus in a Pringles container. So I hope you found that of some interest. And I'm trying to put the lid on now. I can't put the lid on with one hand. I hope you found that of some use, and I would like to know if you make hummus in any other different way, because it's quite, that's the kind of the only way I tend to make hummus. So it would be pretty interesting to know if you make hummus in any different way. Obviously that's a sin-free hummus, but it'd be interesting to know if you put any like sins and stuff in it, and if you put any olive oil in, and if you put like, whether you do the whole tahini thing, or put just kind of raw sesame seeds in as like the healthy extra, or you know, all that kind of stuff. So that'd be interesting. Thank you so much for watching, I will see you next time. Bye bye.